in a feature-length episode tonight at 9:35 here on RT1. Now, Carol goes behind Dan's back on Fair City.
Makes you think.
Yeah. Better to get life cover with Chill Insurance.
Insurance without the drama. Chill Insurance. We'll take it from here.
From Dagan?
Not yet.
Well, but then it might not be too late. I have to get back to him. Tell him that this is a mistake.
Carol.
Handing yourself in isn't going to make a difference to Phil's life.
It'll make a difference to mine.
How?
I'm paying for what I did.
What if you end up in prison?
So be it. I'll be okay.
Well, I won't. I haven't slept with Rory.
For the first time in 2 years, I slept great.
Yeah? Well, you need your head examined. Dan.
This is something I should have done in the first place.
Well, I hope that sister of yours is pleased with herself. Dan's after handing himself into Deegan.
Legs 11, I know.
Kelly's eye. That's one.
Uh-huh.
I thought one little duck was one.
No, I think that's two.
Ah. I'll be sitting beside you two ducks on Sunday.
Do I'm going to tackle my boss today. See if I can get a one-night midweek getaway.
Midweek?
No, I'd stay in a hotel any night of the week, as long as it's free.
But you're not there very long. Well, would it not make things awkward for you?
No, it won't.
If you don't ask, the answer's always no.
Yeah, the bidding is for good cause. He should see that, I mean, especially at Christmas.
Speaking of which, you all set?
God, you must be joking. Not at all. Working Christmas Eve doesn't help.
Well, why don't you pair come here? It'd be nice to have dinner with Doug, you know, and take the pressure off you, especially if you're working on Christmas Eve.
I've already said that we're going to Wayne's. Yeah, Orla wants to make it a special family day.
Oh, yeah, of course she does. It's Junior's first Christmas.
Yeah, that's not a problem. I'm actually really looking forward to spending it with Doug. All righty, talk to you.
You don't mind?
No, sure, I'll get to see Doug at some stage.
Yeah, of course you will. Anyway, I better be heading myself, all right? See you.
Yeah, sure.
Another tea, Charlie?
Just a bill, Yvonne, please.
Now, Zoe, if you're late for rehearsals, Mrs. Hannon will find another camel.
I don't even have a line.
Yeah, but you're the lead camel. That's a very important role.
If it wasn't for the camels, the first Christmas presents wouldn't even have been delivered.
I suppose.
Would you like something?
That was that.
So, making a list and checking it twice, Charlie?
Right. How will you look?
Yeah, I'm taking him into town later to see the lights. Well, for me to see the lights, really, so.
I remember our Tony at Junior's age. You know, he was so mesmerised by our tree, he couldn't take his eyes off it.
That's really cute.
You know, when he got older, he would always be the first one down on Christmas morning. He'd be so excited, he'd open our Bairnie's presents too.
Well, my sister never played with her own presents, she always played with mine, so. Charlie, are you okay?
I've got a lot to do.
Are you coming to my nativity play?
It's on Friday.
Oh, I don't think I could make it.
Well, you'd be very welcome.
Yes, well, I'm far too busy.
Bye, Charlie.
Is Charlie okay?
He's just a little sad.
Yeah, he misses Esther, but he'll be fine.
So are you and Junior going to come?
Just try and stop us. Looks like Wayne will be working a double shift on Friday.
Right, come on, you in school.
See you.
Bye. Bye, Julie.
So you finally decided to come in?
I bumped into Carol. Dan's confessed to the guards. Happy now?
I didn't want that.
Really?
We're not open yet.
Yeah, well, the door was open, Caoimhe. Could have the place robbed. Is Dan around?
No, he said he'd be back in a minute. Oh.
Hi, Liz.
Hey.
Don't waste any time.
Oh, I thought I'd feng shui the office a bit. You don't mind, do you?
It's okay. You're the manager now.
Manager?
I know. I was just as surprised.
You deserve it.
Thank you.
There's a few suppliers you can negotiate better deals with. I'll write up a list.
Oh, great. I'll get on to it today.
And I'll be sorting out your contract later.
I'm liking this new Dan.
Nice promotion for Quiva there.
I'm stepping back. I need to be able to focus on what's ahead. You can't stop this from happening.
I know. I can see that now. You look more relieved.
Carol, Dan.
Right.
I've heard back from the guards in Salt Hill. They're reopening the McGrath case.
So what next?
It's going to take them a few days to go over all the evidence again, but they will want to speak to you down in Galway.
He'll be there. We both will.
I'll be in touch.
I don't expect you to wait for me if I go to prison. You don't have to do this if it's too difficult.
I'm with you.
Are you sure?
Look, you need me, all right? And I'm seeing you through this, whether you like it or not.
Have I got any choice?
No, you don't. Can't get rid of me that easily.
Thanks.
Hi, Dolores.
Hiya.
Wait up for a sec.
Bye. Now. Silly Denani. Who's the best boy, eh? Oh.
Are you going anywhere nice?
Yeah, I'm going to go start my Christmas shopping. Why don't you come with me? You can help me pick out something for wine.
I can't leave Kerry Ann.
You're the boss, Dolores.
No, we're flat out in there.
Well, I hope you're not overdoing it. So your hospital appointment, have you heard anything back from them yet?
Not yet.
You haven't told them?
There's nothing to tell. If and when, you know, there's something we have to deal with, well, he'll be the first to know. So Christmas Day, do you need me to bring anything?
Sorry, Dave.
Where were you?
I got delayed.
Look, McNally's is a new accountant, right? So you pick up their package first. You need to impress them.
I'll sing Jingle Bells.
Hey, Anna.
Hey.
So where's Juliet? Leave said she was over.
Yeah, no, yeah. Joe's minding her for the moment.
Oh.
She would like to see her little cousin, though.
Oh, yeah, of course you can.
Yeah, I'll drop her over later.
Yeah, I do.
Cool,
yeah.
Maybe a sleepover?
Oh, do you know, I'm working late and Wayne's pretty wrecked, so.
Yeah, no, that's okay. I understand. It's fine.
Okay, do you know what? Just leave with me and see what I can do, okay?
Okay.
Okay, see you.
See you.
You shouldn't have to do this. Run around after Mondo and Julia, you know, cleaning up their mess.
Well, I didn't do it all on my own. Julia gave me a hand.
If you say so.
Hello. Ah, Cassia, come on up.
What's this?
Oh, Juliet left them for you.
Really? How did she know I like this?
Well, she asked me and I told her. See, I told you. She's not a bad kid.
No, I suppose not. It's her dad that's the problem.
Where's my great-granddaughter? She's got my mom, though. We took the day off.
He's not with her. I just seen her in the pig.
By herself?
Joe was looking after her till Mondo gets back from doing the delivery.
Right, Mondo's not going to get away with this. Right, Cass, come on.
Yeah.
We're going to get Juliet.
Ah, man. No, you're just in time. This job is a referral, right? It's a snag list on a small extension. Their builders can't do it this side of Christmas, but we can. All right, out with it. What's on your mind?
Nothing.
Don't tell me you're after destroying the house again, eh?
No. Shouldn't I get the drain fixed?
You did by asking me to do it.
Hey.
Hey.
Got the prize for the bingo.
Oh, better woman.
Oh, well, he said no at first, so I piled on the pressure, and then he threw in dinner for two as well.
Well, Dolores will be pleased with that.
So you all set for meeting Emma later?
Yeah, I think so.
You'll be fine.
Of course he will. No problem to you. Just be yourself, all right?
Actually, I don't know. Well, I'd be careful with the aftershave, if I was you.
Why, do you not like it?
I think your mother's trying to tell you less is more, Doug.
Yeah, took your dad a few years to learn that. Brute 33. You used to douse yourself with it.
Yeah, we have to do something to hide the whiff of fear, don't we, Doug?
All right, want a full report later on. And I saw your shirt, by the way. Good choice.
Nice one.
All righty, good luck.
See you.
Right. Now, about Christmas.
all us having this big Malloy family day for little Junior, and, myself and Dolores are invited.
Okay. It's just, it'd be nice to see me ma and dad on Christmas Day, you know?
Yeah, it would, and you'll see me, there'll be no problem with that, all right?
Dan went to the guards about Phil McGrath. I thought you should know.
Hold on. He did what?
He spoke to the guards.
When?
I don't know.
So you think you can walk in here and drop that bombshell and just go? And what's this mean for me?
Look, you did Dan a favor that night and go away. Maybe he hasn't even said anything about you.
Maybe. That's not much of a reassurance. I'm gonna need more than that.
Well, look, even if he did mention your name, you'd be fine. You helped Phil get to the hospital that night.
What, do you think the guardie are gonna see you like that?
I don't know.
No, you don't.
I'll speak to him. I'll find out what he said.
No. You don't have to go anywhere near Dan. You've done enough damage. I'll deal with him.
Look, if you're that concerned about the guards, why don't you just go? Disappear again.
You'd just love that, wouldn't you? Dan banged up, me gone. No. You've messed with me for the last time. Now, Dan going to prison wasn't part of this outcome.
Yeah, but I didn't know he was going to turn himself into the guards.
Yeah, but he did because of you. Now, you better hope, Yvonne, for your sake, that Dan keeps me out of this. Get out.
Oh, Bob, you haven't seen my daughter, Juliet. So I left her inside, but she's not there now.
No, I'm sorry. I'm just starting my shift. Have you seen Mondo's daughter?
No.
How long were you gone?
Oh, I don't know, 15 minutes, maybe 20. I got delayed in the delivery.
You left her and went to work. They should have neutered you at birth.
If this is a worried parent who can't find his daughter, a little sympathy wouldn't go amiss.
I'm sure she'll turn up.
Look, I'll phone the staff who did the early shift and see if they know it.
Okay, great. No, do you know what? She's probably with my dad anyway, so...
No, take it.
No, it's one of my customers.
All right, okay. You will let me know?
Yeah, of course.
Sure. Good luck.
Cheers.
You're not a bit worried that Cuiva's going to squander all your money.
She's a good worker. Would you prefer if I made you a manager?
Not if you're paying her that, no. What the hell is he doing here?
Bobby, there's 10 grand on that. Enough to get you far away as possible.
He can never give you what I can.
Like cheaper car insurance?
Insurance without the drama.
Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
It's that time of year when the world falls in love. Every song you hear seems to say, Merry Christmas, may your New Year's dreams come true. And this song of mine, in three-quarter time, wishes you and yours the same thing too.
Take that! Second and final date added. Tickets on sale this Thursday at 9 a.m. from Ticketmaster.
Together with the people you love. Every meal is a special occasion. IKEA, a wonderful every day.
Go on, say it.
Okay, okay, yes. Should have called Chill Insurance.
Insurance without the drama.
I don't want your money.
Fuck, take it. It's better than going to prison.
You don't care what happens to me. What are you doing here?
I helped Yvonne plant the illegal booze. Look, I was angry with both of you.
Is that what the money's for? To ease your conscience?
No. Look, I told you to run after we left Phil at the hospital, and I'd do it again. But that night in Galway, we were in it together.
That's why you're really here. You're worried I ratted on you.
Well, did you?
I didn't say anything.
Well, I knew you wouldn't.
So why'd you ask?
Come on, take it. I owe you.
Well, maybe you should think about it, Dan.
I already have. Get out.
Don't throw away your life like this.
I said get out.
Come on, you're making a big mistake. Well, you know where I am. Carol.
It's better this way.
Why aren't you on work?
I can't find Julie anywhere. I thought you might have called in to see Junior.
I can't. Well, look, when I was that age, my gran didn't see me from morning till night, right?
Doesn't say anything, really.
What's the idea of leaving Juliet and a pig like Dapper?
What?
John told me.
Well, where is she?
I'm brought to see Neve. She's up there now.
And you let me worry myself sick?
I tried to ring you, but you wouldn't answer your phone.
So, look, look, I told you she'd be grand, didn't I?
But you told me you were going to spend the day with her.
I did, but most of it. But he wouldn't let me off.
Hang on, don't go blaming me on this.
So this is you being responsible, huh? Ditching your 11-year-old daughter. Now, you know what he's up, pal.
Here, Deck. I need a favour, you know, a few days off.
I can't do it.
It's for Juliet. She needs me, you know? I'll make it up to you, I promise.
No, it's the busiest time of the year. I can't do it.
Deck.
Look, it's not my problem, right?
Now, there you are.
Everybody wants Christmas off.
Listen, trying to roast over Christmas every year is an absolute nightmare.
Yeah, it's tricky. But it's our busiest time of year. We have to stay open.
Yeah, well, I'm lucky, I suppose. I get to get Christmas Day off. Even my burgers are no competition for a good turkey dinner.
Hi.
Hello.
Hey, Laura.
Pete, Tommy, your boss said yes. Thanks very much.
No, it's nothing.
Can I get you anything?
Oh, I can't stop. We're one of our feet over there. I'm here about the bingo.
Oh, yes. There you go. 5 €10 vouchers as agreed.
Oh, come on. You can do better than that. We're expecting a big turnout.
Jackie's right.
Think of the promotion.
Well, seeing as you put it like that, I'll throw another couple in.
I'll make it 5 more and we leave you alone.
There's a deal I can't refuse. I bet you're glad she's on your side.
I am, yeah.
Well, the bingo's all Dolores' idea.
Yeah, and you drive the hard bargains. I'll drop them over to you later.
Thanks, Bob. I better get back.
Hey, you.
That's the second shower to go in 2 days.
Yeah, I'll give Pete a call.
Ah, more of a necessary expense. I'm going to have to keep a closer eye on who's going up and down those stairs.
Charlie, you look as if you're going to splinter with worry. What happened?
Scroungers, that's what.
We think people are using the centre's facilities to wash because of the water charges.
Yeah, well, there must be. I mean, class numbers haven't risen, but the traffic through here has.
I mean, you can't blame folk for trying to scrimp and save in these hard times. What'll it be next? Oxygen meters.
There are 2 broken showers upstairs because members of the public are taking advantage of our service.
Which 2?
Does it matter?
Oh, no, just asking.
Where are you going?
I have a class, yoga, I think.
You're not booked in for anything. Open that bag. Cass? You're going for a shower, aren't you?
Well, I was just trying to save myself and Bella some money.
At a cost to the community service. We have to pay for our water too, you know. How are we going to keep this place open with the likes of him taking advantage, huh?
Look, I'll go over the books later and see what's what. We might have to cut back in other areas.
Now, don't let me catch you going up those stairs. If you'll excuse me, I have to cancel this evening's classes.
So the Rin boys dress up and perform plays on St. Stephen's Day?
Sometimes, yeah. But they do other days as well, like just only over the Christmas.
So they come into your home?
No. They do it outside on the street.
And it's only men?
I think so. I've never heard of the Wren girls, and anyway,
But why did they name them after their bird?
Must be into bird watching. You know, the wren is very popular here.
I'll be back in a minute. Then you can tell me more.
Peace offering. You're right. I shouldn't have left Juliet.
And where is she now?
Well, she wanted to see Rachel en route. But Neva's offered to take her again tomorrow.
But you can't do that.
But Neva's working from home. She's fine with it.
Juliet needs to spend some time, Radha. And that to you, in case you forgot.
I don't have the time. No, between work and finalising the details for Las Vegas.
You're not still on about that.
A mate of mine there is after offering me a casino job. I've been in contact with the manager.
And what do you know about working in a casino?
I learn. I'm doing this for Juliet.
What? The only thing that you ever did for that kid was to let her down. You'll never change.
I'm trying to make a better life for us.
Oh, and do you have a green card?
You know I don't.
So you're going to work illegally? And what happens when you want to come home? You might get back in again. And who knows when you're going to see Juliet again? What you need to do is to find a time to see her now before you go traipsing off to Las Vegas.
So?
So I was saying, the wren boy has killed the wren because of its treachery.
It's treachery?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah, you'd be amazed.
But it's such a small bird. What could it possibly do?
The prehistoric wren was big.
Prehistoric?
It was huge. It ravaged the land, had to be hunted.
Are you sure about this?
I am. Okay, I'm not.
Thanks.
Maybe we could do something tomorrow. Jack. Carol.
Yeah, all right. See if we can get cover.
We could get a photo with Santa. A photo for his knee.
Oh, Dan, will you stop, will you? Stop pretending that all this is okay, that everything's normal. Going to see Santa.
I just want to have nice memories, the three of us, you know, before I go.
That's just it. You don't have to go to prison. Look, I've been thinking, all right? Robbie's right. You should take the money. Listen to me. We could go and we could stay with Ali for a bit.
Carol, I'm not running.
All right, well, then use the money and get yourself a hotshot barrister.
We've been over this. I want nothing from Robbie.
And what about Jack? Huh? He's mad about you. Dan, I knew girls years back whose fellas went inside. It's tough. Most of them don't last.
You said you'd stand by me.
I did. And I will.
I have to do this.
Oh, hi, Jackie.
Can I have a juice?
Yes, of course.
Thanks.
Actually, can I take one of these?
You promise you'll leave me alone. Well, be careful. She'll have you emptying your handbag before you know it.
Yes, Scrooge here is just a little bit sore after emptying his pockets. I'm helping Dolores with the bingo.
Oh, she never said. Well, I suppose we will have a full house, so...
Hopefully.
Don't give up your day job, though.
Thanks.
Thanks.
That outfit you got him is adorable.
Aw, thanks. Listen, Dolores, you must be really happy that Jackie's giving you a hand with the bingo.
I suppose.
It's me. You don't have to bite your tongue. Come on.
Well, she's everywhere I go for a start. Pete even asked her to join us for Christmas. Well, don't worry, she said no.
Good.
I wish she wasn't so involved in my life, or Pete. She relies on him way too much.
No, don't worry. It's all going to settle down, OK?
Maybe you're right.
Mm-hmm. We'll see you.
Yeah.
Bye.
Come in. A secret text to meet up.
Don't.
Where no one can see us. You always knew how to grab my attention.
I want you to go to the guards for Dan. I want you to tell them that you were there, that you made him run.
A
Is this a joke?
It's not fair that Dan goes down for Phil. You said it yourself, yous were in it together.
It's not gonna get Dan off.
I could reduce his sentence.
Dan's only chance is to clear away from here. Now, the offer of the money still stands. We could persuade him together.
Can't know him here.
Why not?
Doesn't want your help.
Oh, is that the real reason?
I don't want him to go to prison.
Well, I mightn't come to that.
Phil is brain damaged. They're not going to let Dan off easy. But you could help.
Look, Dan was a soldier. He's been through worse than that and survived.
This is different. He has to live with what he's done to Phil for the rest of his life. He doesn't need to suffer any more than that.
Hey. Look, this is all Dan's choice. Come on.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I just got all worked up.
No, no, you're okay.
You could put this right, Robbie. Please. You owe him.
The story continues tomorrow night at 8. Over on RTE2 tonight, reality bites on Smack 'Em Up when cameras follow Fergal Devitt, one of the biggest names in the world of Japanese pro wrestling. That's on 2 at 9. Here on RTE1 after the main evening news, see at first the feature-length finale of The Fall, Gibson's chilled by Spectre's ego and cruelty. The story reaches a dramatic conclusion starting at 9.35 tonight.
The test results?
No, the home renewal. We need to switch to Chill Insurance.
Insurance, without the drama. Chill Insurance. We'll take it from here. Hi, Miss.